In 1976, Joseph Gumwok, a Nigerian Commissioner of Police and the first military governor of Benue Plateau State after the creation of states on May 27, 1967, was arrested, screened, tried, and then subsequently acquitted after the charges against him were dismissed. This was due to his perceived connections to the February 13, 1976 abortive coup against Nigeria's third military head of state, Muritala Mohammed. However, Gumwok would be arraigned again and retried. This time, he was convicted and executed on May 15, 1976. What really led to Gumwok's execution in Lagos is still a subject matter, even to this day. Born Joseph Dichi Gumwok on April 13, 1935, Gumwok was an Ngaz from Apang or Pang, present-day Kanke local government area of Plateau State. He attended the prestigious boys' secondary school Gendiri near Jos, where he graduated with distinctions not just in academics but also sports. Gumwok then proceeded to the University of Ibadan, where he graduated in 1961 with a first-class degree in zoology. He then joined the famous Northern Region Civil Service and was made a division officer in the province of Sardana, but eventually transferred his services to the Federal Ministry of Agriculture, rising to the level of Principal Assistant Secretary by February 1966. After advanced training at Scotland Yard and the Federal Bureau of Investigation, the FBI, he was assigned to the Nigerian Police Force as Chief Superintendent of its Elite Special Branch. In July 1966, Gumwok had got wind of the Northern Counter Coup that was to reach its apex in Ibadan. As a result, he informed his superior Joseph Adeola, who was then the Commissioner of Police in Western Nigeria, to alert the Head of State and Supreme Commander, General Johnson Thomas Aguiranci, who was on a visit, and his host, Lieutenant Colonel Francis Adekunle Fadjui, of an impending rebellion. The Police Commissioner would, however, err on the side of caution, as he could not alert Fadjui and Aguiranci early enough. 5 days later, on August 4, 1966, Gumwok led a team of policemen to recover the bodies of the now murdered Aguiranci and Fadjui from a shallow grave near the town of Lalupon, which is at the outskirts of Ibadan. In May 1967, Gumwok became a major beneficiary of the very coup that he almost foiled, if not for Adeola's prevarication. Nevertheless, the new head of state, Lieutenant Colonel Yakubu Gowon, who was also his kinsman, appointed him as the military governor of Benue Plateau State after the regions were broken down into 12 states. The Benue Plateau State was to be later broken down into 3 more states, Benue, Plateau, and Nasarawa, with capitals at Makurdi, Jos, and Lafia, respectively. Joseph Gumwok, a visionary leader while governor, started the Nigerian Standard, a government-owned daily newspaper, in 1972. As of 2003, the paper, which was located in Jos, the capital city, had a circulation of around 100,000 copies per day. After the Ahmadu Bello University of Zaria refused to grant Gumwok's request to open a satellite campus in Jos, the governor turned to the University of Ibadan, who then opened its Jos campus in November 1971. It would later metamorphosize to the University of Jos in October 1975. On Friday, February 13, 1976, the head of state, General Muritala Mohammed, was assassinated in an abortive coup while on his way to work. The aftermath of this assassination has generated diverse debates that remained unresolved to date. For example, the president of the Special Military Tribunal that tried the alleged coup d'etat back in 1976, Major General John Obada, stated in a July 3, 2010 Vanguard newspaper interview that the Lieutenant Colonel B.S. Dimka coup d'etat was a very complicated thing because it was a coup within a coup. The general did not provide specifics of the coup within a coup, but claimed that Dimka was not ambitious but motivated by greed and gross indiscipline. It is as a result of these investigations that Joseph Dichi Gumwok was arrested, screened, and tried, and was subsequently acquitted with the charges against him dismissed, only for him to be arraigned again and retried, then convicted under debatable circumstances. The Obada-led court that tried, discharged, and absolved Gumwok was disbanded. Another military court was formed and headed by Brigadier General Pius Eremobo, who retrieved the acquittal of the former governor and sentenced him to death. Joseph Gumwok was executed on May 15, 1976 in Lagos, the federal capital. Minority officers from the Middle Belt were the scapegoat of the time. The friction between the officers of the Middle Belt and those from the far north resurfaced, and the coup investigation took proportions of witch hunting, and the officers were convicted on the weakest or most circumstantial evidence, mostly relying on Dimka's uncorroborated testimony. JD, as Gumwok is still fondly known, is so branded on the memory of his kinsmen and his supposed presence without the declassification of the court-martial records of 1976 is at best circumstantial and will remain in the domain of speculation.